Hello everyone, so in this video we're going to address the problem that many of you have. Many of you have only 15 years of education, that is including your 3 years of bachelor's degree that you're doing, and which is not allowing you to apply to many of the universities in the US or in other countries because they accept only up till 16 years of education. So how do you counter that? So Jayashree over here did only 15 years of education, and after that she went on and pursued and did another 1 year degree. And she got it up to 16. But even if you have only 15 years of education, there are still some universities who accept that and are willing to take you. But there are some conditions. So basically, we're going to cover all of that. And after that, we will also cover how to get that extra 1 year of education that you need to apply to universities. So Jayashree, can you talk about how to get into universities when you have only 15 years of education?
Okay. So to start with, I would say that I would recommend to get a 4-year degree first, if possible. Mm-hmm. But in certain circumstances, that is not possible. Like, I never planned to come to US, and I had a bachelor's degree that was 3 years, but later I realized that I want to go, and there was no way I can go back and change that.
Yes,
right?
You did a BCA, right?
Yeah, I did bachelor's in computer application. That is a 3-year degree after grade 12.
Yes.
All right. So now there are different options you can work around this. First, there is a list of university that such a you can provide, probably put the list.
Yeah, I'll put the link down in the description.
Yeah, so those university, they accept 15 years of education from India. However, your university needs to be NA accredited by NAAC, and you need to have your percentage that is in Division 1. That's one criteria. If this requirements are not being met, and if the university that you're targeting does not accept a 15 year of undergraduation given these conditions, what you can do is you can do 1 year of a postgraduate diploma that I did.
Okay. All right. So to reiterate, basically your university needs to be A accredited, right?
Yeah.
And on top of that, you need to be passing with Division 1, right? You need to have that much amount of grade.
Right.
So based on that, these are some universities that you can apply to. Again, this is not an exhaustive list. Maybe you can search for more universities and you will find them. But again, this makes your choices really, really limited. So what we would suggest you to do is maybe add another year of education to that. And you can use that education to have 16 years in your pocket, and then you can start applying to universities, which will help you a lot. All right. So do you think you can talk about that experience, how to get that 1 year course and what happens after you do that?
Yeah. So I think there are ample amount of option on what you can do for that 1 year course. Since I wanted to choose a software engineering track and I had done bachelor's in computer applications, I thought doing a post-graduation diploma in information technology made more sense to me because then subjects were relevant to what I wanted to pursue. So depending upon what you want to do for your master's, choose a diploma degree accordingly. Like, I was also considering doing a master's in India, which will be 2 years, and then coming here. But then I realized that would be like too much wasting my time, efforts. And then in the meantime, I happened to find this option, and it worked out best. And also to save time, what I did was, as is like when you give GRE, TOEFL, apply for universities, it takes about a year to do all of this and then you come. In that 1 year, what you can do is you can also start your diploma degree and simultaneously do GRE, TOEFL, apply for universities. That's what I did, and that's how I saved my 1 year. And there will come a point when you will see that what about transcripts, because you get the admissions in the month of March, April, and you would only get the transcript when you finish your course, which will be in June, July.
Yeah.
So what you can do is you can request your university to give you a letter saying that you are a student and you will be completing your education in June, July. And you can give that letter to your university in United States. They do accept that letter, and they can wait for your transcript to come once you finish your diploma. So I only submitted a transcript once I was here physically in USA.
So basically what you mean to say is people don't need to waste their time doing a master's in India. What they can do is just a 1 year course.
Yeah.
In a post-graduation course. What was the course name exactly?
My was post-graduation in information technology from Mumbai University.
Is it called something like master's, M.Tech?
What is it? It's called PGDIT.
PGDIT.
Yeah.
Okay. PGDIT.
PGDIT is a short form, basically.
Okay. Post-graduation
diploma in information technology.
Post-graduation diploma in information technology.
Yeah. So it's not a master's degree; it's a post-graduation degree.
That works, right? 16 years of education. So basically, your university can give out a letter for you stating that the transcripts can be received later, and US universities in the US will accept that. She got into Northeastern, which did not have any criteria of accepting people who just had 15 years of education. So that is one example for you guys to take.
Yeah.
All right. Is there anything that you want to add to this, or is that all?
I think mostly that's the information. And if you have any follow-up questions, you can send those questions to me on LinkedIn, and I would be more than happy
to
help.
I will link her LinkedIn profile down below, guys. If you have any questions, you can reach out to her. But I think she was able to answer most of your questions, most of your doubts. And what we believe is that you should be pursuing a 16 years of education. If you can't do engineering, obviously then only you're watching this video because you have been doing a diploma or something of that sort, or bachelor's, which has only 3 years of education. So please add another 1 year of education there by doing a postgraduate, and that will help you a lot. All right. Again, her LinkedIn will be down below. You can reach out to her with your questions, and she'll be more than happy to help you guys out. Thank you so much for watching, guys.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.